They call me for certain things. And I, being a father that I am, I come to their rescue and help them. Even though they've grown and on their own, but they still call me as a dad. Dad, this is going on. Dad, I have this problem. Hallelujah. Glory to God. And I come to their aid. Here I am coming to their aid. What about your father? Your father God. Hallelujah. You mean you don't trust him enough to come to your aid in your situation or your circumstance you may be going through? But ask him. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Bless you, Lord. Hallelujah. Bless you, Lord. Thank you, Father. Verse 50, if ye know that he heareth us, whatsoever we have, we know that we have the petition that we desire him. Thank you, Lord God. Praise you, Lord. Glory to God. And when you begin to think on that, I think your hand ought to go up and say, thank you, Lord Jesus. Praise you, Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord, for coming to my rescue. Coming to my aid, Father God. I thank you, Lord, that you are my helper. You are my protector. You are my shield and my fortress. I thank you, Father God. In the name of Jesus, for all that you're doing. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. And this last of this rest testimony. And hallelujah. Because, you know, it pays to praise the Lord. Hallelujah. That particular day that the tornado hit Joplin, and we were at home, some of the family, we were just, you know, relaxing, chilling, and fellowshipping. You know what we do when we fellowship? We eat, and, you know, and I think we were watching a movie or whatever. And I think Sister Jessica, she called us, told us about the storm that was up there in Joplin had affected some of their family. And she told me, might want to check on calling them. And my wife called up there and talked with them. And of course, you know, they said everything was fine other than they was, you know, had no electric or what have you. I mean, my arms, like I said, can't reach way up there. My arms can't reach way to South Tulsa where my kids live. But I know God can. Hallelujah. The Bible says his arm is not short that he cannot say, nor is his ears heavy that he cannot hear. He's not so busy, praise God, with this and here that he don't hear you. Hallelujah. You can call upon him, hallelujah, in the midnight hour. Glory to God. In the evening hour, in the morning hour. Hallelujah. His eyes and ears are open to the cry of the righteous. And he stands ready to bring deliverance for them, those that are his. And he knoweth those that are his. Hallelujah. Glory to God. I'm beginning to see perfection, praise God, a different light. You know, it's more of obedience. Now, you know, than you doing everything on the dot and the T, even if you did everything dot to the T, the Bible said, our righteousness is that of a guilty wrath. We just see ourselves, we're like Christ sees us. Hallelujah. And what he done. Hallelujah. And cover ourselves in the blood of Jesus Christ. And my wife was telling me, we were talking about that, about nuns. And she said, it's, you know, it's still important to be holy. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. Glory to God. It's still required, praise God, for us to walk according to God's word. In the fear and respect of him. Not live a lifestyle of doing anything and every kind of thing. Glory to God. We still to be able to walk in the light of his word. Thank you, Lord God. And because when you, that'll give you confidence to stay, be in his presence. Because when sin is, the Bible said, man regarded iniquity in his heart, God would not hear him. Hallelujah. So you want to be in a place where God will hear you. And when you pray, thank you, Father. Hallelujah. So I am truly grateful for all what God has done. Hallelujah. Throughout my life and through the life of my loved ones and my family, I protected them and kept them, praise God. And it's been worth it. It seemed like, you know, such a small time out of your life to come out on Monday night. A small time to come out of that on Wednesday night. Yes. Glory to God. Sunday morning. Yes. Glory to God. Don't see it as a burden, or burdensome, or bothersome, or even a sacrifice. Hallelujah. But you ought to be willing to do this joyfully. For all the many times that he kept you and protected you, praise God, that you didn't even know nothing about it. But these are just some of the things that God had did in my life and kept me and protected me, hallelujah, that I just share a portion of it. There are many other things that God has shown himself, and I see him move, praise God, and you just, you know, you think, sometimes you think it's you reacting. It ain't nothing got to do with you reacting. Your mind is focused on that moment and what's going on, where you want to go to. But at a split instant, he dispatched an angel on your side to protect you, to cover you, to shield you. And you didn't know nothing about it. Hallelujah. Glory to God. I mean, we thank God. Hallelujah. This is a praying church to believe in prayer. To believe in serving God and seeking God. And like I say, I encourage you. I mean, to find your place. I mean, like I said, prayer, the Bible said, his house should be the house of prayer.
There you go, there you go.
Glory to God. Glory to God. Matter of fact, Paul even did it, took it just to pray without ceasing. Hallelujah. Man should always pray and talk of fame. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Thank you, Father. In the name of Jesus. I thank you for taking this time to listen to me. But, you know, out of everything, you know, that I have shared, and encourage you. And this is what it's all about, just encouraging one another in the Lord, and I will walk with the Lord. And, you know, just to press, praise God, beyond that you might receive. I like the scripture that Paul said, he looked past death, which is the joy that was set before him. I mean, that's why I think we need to put some joy before us. Instead of our circumstances, our situation, what we're going through, put some joy before you. Because if you put joy before you, especially this word, you'll make it through that, what you're going through.
Yes.
Hallelujah. And you got to remember, you know, Job's situation that he was going through. You know, and then I began to reflect on it this morning. You know, Job went through a whole lot of different things in the verses in his life. But God knew what Job was going to do. Job wasn't going backwards. That's the testimony that God had of Job. Hallelujah, of his faithfulness. I trust Job. Even though he lost this, his wife, a lot of things, family, a lot of possession, yet he trusted God. Hallelujah. And that's the resolve that we have to have. No matter what you might be facing, no matter what you're going through, you still is going to trust the Lord. Hallelujah. Amen. Praise the Lord. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah.
I'm proud of the brothers today. Yeah. Can they do a good job? I don't think they're put too close to hand, you know? All right. Yeah. Brothers gave the women a run for their money. Amen. That was good. That really struck me, that scripture. You know, I've been reading that for 20 or 30 years, but that struck me a different way. God doesn't hear a sinner pray. But if any man be a worshiper, with the emphasis on worshiper, and doeth his will, him God will hear.
Hallelujah.
Oh, hallelujah. Boy, I think that worship focus is the direction that God is dealing with this ministry. Now, amen, if you want to get out of the mess you're in, if you want to get out of the situation you're in, if you want your circumstances, hallelujah, altered, or your direction turned around. Hallelujah. I believe that Brother Wayne was saying that Monday night when you get out of here, come out here, you ought to just worship. Sunday morning, rather than waiting until all prayer's over. So you're missing your blessing. You are missing your blessing. Amen. Come and what? Worship. Get excited about God and what he has promised. Oh, glory. God can change you from an alley rat to an aristocrat. Hallelujah. From the guttermost to the uttermost. If you would just pull out your heart and worship. Now, this is a challenge. And this is the thing that can turn your life completely in a different direction. If you can just give heed to that revelation today that we got to worship. We got to get excited about all of these provisions and all of these promises and blessings that God has amen, given us, and we begin to what? Worship him. If we delight in him, he said, he will give us the desires of our heart. How many want the desires of your heart? How many want to receive the desires of your heart? Not too many of y'all. I want you to